A new breed of virus that has the medical community scrambling for answers has now claimed the lives of over 150 people. The entire city has been evacuated and is now under strict quarantine. The first known case of the virus was found after six-year-old twin sisters Tiffany and Teresa Morrissey were admitted to the hospital just weeks ago. The virus quickly spread among the hospital's medical staff, forcing the area to be quarantined and on high alert. With one of the twins dead, within days of contracting the virus, the surviving sister, Teresa, has made a full recovery. The only reported case of anyone showing any signs of immunity to the virus. Now, one microbiologist believes that Theresa Morrissey is the key to finding a cure, that perhaps somewhere in her DNA lies the answer to this epidemic that has forced residents to abandon their homes and leave the city. And it's now being reported, I can tell you, that the surviving twin, Theresa Morrissey, is missing. She was last seen by her father at Oxford Station on Thursday, but was apparently lost during the chaos of the evacuation. We will bring you continued coverage of the story as it develops. For now, this case begs the question, where is Theresa Morrissey?
Morning, Doctor. Your paperwork is in. You've been cleared to return to Oxford to find the missing girl. If your research is accurate, then this girl is the key to finding a cure. It's imperative that you find her. We don't want this thing going global. The girl's grandfather ran a farm not too far from the drop-off point. That's probably a good place to start your investigation. We've scheduled a train to take you into Oxford this afternoon. Good luck, Doc.
Thank you. Thank you. Something around here to eat.
Thank you. Thank you. Off me earlier. Sorry for being a schmuck and running away like that, but can't be too careful these days. What are you, a doctor? You certainly look sterile with them fancy gloves. That big old fella with the mask just headed downtown. Didn't look too pleased. That your fault, is it? And the two of you are the first signs of life I've seen in days. Figured it was just me and that little girl left in this rotten place. I warned people this kind of thing was coming. So, the little girl is immune, is she? I figured as much. Me? No, I'm not. I just don't have much contact with people anymore, and I try to stay away from the water. Never liked it anyway! The only food that's safe to eat anymore is sealed up in them vending machines. And those things are impenetrable! Tell you what. You find me something safe to eat, I'll help you get into that shop down the street. I'm willing to bet they've got something in there that'll help you defend yourself against that heavy-breathing you-know-who. Hey, you find me something to eat yet? Something salty would be nice. Avoid the liquids.
My big teeth are catch my drift. Thank you.
You pulled through! Eating like a king tonight, I tell you. Right. The door code for the shop. 7417. Or is it 7147? Never been too good with numbers, admittedly. But I think that's the right one. One of the two ought to do the trick. Well, what's the worst that can happen?
Oxford, where house fire is currently roaring out of control. As you can hear, the fire department is on their way. While the cause of the fire is still unknown, neighbors think that the fire may have been deliberately set. One resident, who prefers to remain anonymous, reported a disturbance after hearing yelling and screaming coming from outside the house. Only moments later, the house was ablaze. We have no official statement yet from authorities, but it looks like it may be a case of arson. No word yet on injuries or casualties. Bring you continued coverage as the story progresses, right here live and on location.
Thank you. alive. That's all you need to know. Forget about any negotiating. She ain't yours. You made it pretty clear you ain't letting up here anytime soon. So I'm afraid we're gonna have to resort to, well, more persuasive measures. You upset me now. No more chances. This ends right here, right now. Smarter than you look, but I don't think you got it in you. I got bigger things to deal with right now. Watch your back.
It's all right. I'll catch you.
I don't think I can do this. It's too high.
Quickly, Theresa. Jump. I'll catch you.
Jane, are you there? My phone died. I'm on a plane home right now. An ambulance is on its way. Hang in there.
Thank you. Alive and well, I see. Hey, if you're headed to the park across the bridge, you're gonna want to stock up on birdseed. Those flying diseases are out of control.
You could probably find something in that vending machine.
If you have any luck, come back and let me know, would you?
Go. That birdseed will come in handy, I'm telling you. You can thank me later. Night's coming quick. It'll be impossible to find your way through the park at this hour. Gonna need a lantern to light your way. I'll give you mine if you can fish out my other boot I lost there in that lake. Fair trade, I'd say. Deal's a deal. Lantern's all yours. See you around, Doc.
me, aren't you? It's okay, I'm not afraid. I saw you on the news. I don't want to make anybody sick anymore. And I know you're trying to help. But we just got one little problem. Actually, it's kind of a big problem. My daddy. He thinks you're here to hurt me, like the others. I tried to tell him, but he said I can't trust anybody. Here, take this. Maybe he'll listen to you, because you're a grown-up.
Well, well, well. We'll meet again. I see you're a little unprepared this time. No bloodshed in front of my daughter. Consider yourself lucky. Just leave my family alone. This ain't our fault. We didn't ask for this. We ain't leaving. So step away and go on out of here.
A new breed of virus that has the medical community scrambling for answers has now claimed the lives of over 150 people. The entire city has been evacuated and is now under strict quarantine. The first known case of the virus was found after 6-year-old twin sisters Tiffany and Teresa Morrissey were admitted to the hospital just weeks ago. The virus quickly spread among the hospital's medical staff, forcing the area to be quarantined and on high alert. With one of the twins dead, within days of contracting the virus, the surviving sister, Teresa, has made a full recovery. The only reported case of anyone showing any signs of immunity to the virus. Now, one microbiologist believes that Theresa Morrissey is the key to finding a cure, that perhaps somewhere in her DNA lies the answer to this epidemic that has forced residents to abandon their homes and leave the city. And it's now being reported, I can tell you, that the surviving twin, Theresa Morrissey, is missing. She was last seen by her father at Oxford Station on Thursday, but was apparently lost during the chaos of the evacuation. We will bring you continued coverage of the story as it develops. For now, this case begs the question, where is Theresa Morrissey?
I'm sorry. They've all been quite upset, them city folk. Upset with Theresa and her family, saying we started this. I'm a simple man. I don't know how all that stuff works, but I know my family didn't ask for this. You're not the first one to come on back here to Oxford and try and take my little girl from me. They said getting rid of Theresa was the only way to stop all this from spreading.
Final survey of the area completed. Confirming all survivors are cleared. Ready to commence the dismantling of Oxford. Chopper 4 out.
Dismantling of Oxford? Hope that's not what I think it is. We should hurry on out of here. It's too dark to travel through the city, but there's a path behind our house that leads to Oxford Station. Here, this should help us along the way. There's a gate in the back that leads to Oxford Station. You might find something in the house that'll help you open it. To exit Oxford and get away from the blast radius as quickly as possible, two line changes will have to be made to the train tracks. Someone will have to stay back to switch the tracks at the right time. Before we worry about that, we'll need to access the control room beyond this door. It requires two key cards to unlock. I have one of them. My father had the other. The other set of tracks where we first bumped into each other. That's the quickest way back to the barn where my father worked. He kept the key card in his wallet. Check there. You better hurry.
They're blowing the place sky high. So you found the girl, did you? Good job, Doc. Knew you had it in you. Don't you worry about me. I always find my way. The name's Carl, by the way. It's been a pleasure, Doc.
Get on that train. I know these tracks better than you do, so I'll make sure things get switched over at the right time.
But Dad, you're coming too, right?
I'll be okay, Teresa. You stay with the doctor and everything will be okay. I promise. Now go!
Michael Morsi was a brave man. He gave his life that day for the sake of his daughter. And whether he was aware of it or not, for the sake of humanity. But the real work still lies ahead. They say the birds may have spread things overseas, and it could be weeks before they can come up with a working vaccine. Today's fight is won, but the war ain't over. By the sounds of things, we're just getting started.
In summer of 2012, I lost one daughter. And then I lost Theresa. They destroyed my home. And then they made everyone leave Oxford forever. Today, I go back to find my daughter. To find Theresa. Dear wife, Caitlin, been 6 years now since I lost her. She never survived the labor. On that day, I lost one and gained two. Still miss her every day. Rest in peace, Tiffany. Daddy loves you very much and thinks about you every day. Oxford Station. My daddy and I have been running this place since before I can remember. Dad mostly takes care of the farm now, and I focus on general engine repairs to the trains and tractor trailers that come along these parts. I must say, seeing this place so quiet and empty kind of spooks me out just a little bit.
Yeah.
Mercy Ranch. This place has been a staple of our family for years. I had hoped to one day pass it on to my little girls. My little girl again, are they? Not if I have anything to say about it. I should seal up this gate. Don't want Theresa coming along and hurting herself on anything, and it'll eliminate one place she might hide.
Thank you.
someone's coming in on that train. Lost my wife, my father, and one daughter already. I'm not about to lay down and just let these people take Theresa from me. I will defend her at whatever cost, even if my life depends on it.
Thank you.